Right, so do you want to hear a quick demonstration? I've only roughly tuned it, just flung through the tuning and everything, so let's see how well my microphone will pick out the sound. I think it's sounding pretty good so far. So I'm just going to go and tune it. Explaining tuning is another thing like rescaling and restringing, which actually would take ages to tell you everything there is to know. But basically, when you're tuning a piano, that note's in tune at the moment, but I'll show you what it's like when it goes out of tune. Can you hear that? Wow, 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 wow. That's what we're listening for when we're tuning unisons for first off. And a unison is where every note in the treble section of a piano usually has three strings for that one note, and they all are at the same exact pitch, or they should be. The reason that that sounds so rough is that that one of those strings is not actually at the correct pitch, it's slightly off. And what we have to do, bring it in so that it is in pitch. That's unisons. That's what gets rid of the honky-tonk sound of a piano. The next thing we tune is intervals, fourths, fifths and thirds mainly, and then octaves as well after that. And it's all to do with beat rates, which is the wow, wow, wow effect that I was talking about just then. And when you're tuning a piano by ear, you just work through it like that, just constantly. You usually have a tuning fork or some device to give you the correct pitch. You tune either C or A, depending on what school you went to when you were learning or who you learned from. Most people prefer A. Some people prefer C. I actually follow the John Lord scale. Which is how you lay down the middle octave in a piano before working out in the rest of the octaves, just going from there out. That's if I'm tuning by ear. If I'm tuning by a machine, which is a subject for another video, it's a completely different kettle of fish. You start at the bottom of the piano and you work your way up. But I tend to do some tunings by ear, some tunings by machine, depending on noisy environments, piano being off of pitch, the quality of the piano, and numerous other factors as well. So basically what I'm going to do now is just tune this piano, get it all in tune, and then from there on we'll see what it sounds like again. And from that point it really is just final touches, re-regulating again to settle it down because it's still not quite perfect. Another fine tune probably later on this afternoon, and a little bit of felting, put it all together. That's it, we're done. And then I'll make another video about when it's at the concert hall. So, all good stuff. Okay, the action is now regulated. As you can see, it's looking lovely. Phil is finishing off the sostenuto rail.
Trying his best.
And that should be it. And it's now the end of the day. So tomorrow morning, it's getting shipped straight off to the concert hall. So the next video I make, it will actually be at the concert hall, getting tuned up, ready for its first performance, or its settling in performance anyway. So, I didn't actually get to record any video about regulating, which I was going to do, and about how to set this up, but it's going to bed in, and then we're going to have to regulate it again anyway, once it's settled down in its environment, and I'm going to check over to make sure that the keys need, to see if the keys need weighting as well,
bit more voicing as well when it's in the concert hall. So when that all happens, I'll do a video about regulating as well, so you can see what we end up doing with the regulation side of things, because that is a big big thing as well. So yes, so all exciting stuff, and the next couple of videos are going to be most exciting of the lot. So we'll see how that goes. So here we are, back at the Good Oak Concert Hall, around the back. I'll show you around the front in a few minutes, but the piano is actually in that van there, and we're going to get it unloaded without getting run over by the tram. Right, there we are. Piano is now back home. Now, I would have actually done more recording in the concert hall and done a few tunes, but I'm in a bit of a rush. There was a bit of a disaster with a lift being out of service, so I haven't had a lot of time, so I'm an hour later than I thought I was going to be. So now it's just a case of making it to the next job. So I'm about to get hit by a tram. So the story actually doesn't end there. This is just, it's now got to bed in. We're then going to regulate it and voice it to its new environment. So actually I'll do another video soon where we're actually finishing off the project. So watch this space.